pieces. Some people think, I call them transformable artwork. They transform into something different if you want to change it. To give you an example, believe that or not, they're all magnetic. And if I wanted to change the coloration and transform them into something different, you will see it right before your eyes, changing of the artwork. So, this is one of my inventions. I like to invent different things. And I don't think anybody's ever done anything like this before, and I think that's probably the reason I'm doing artwork with magnets, is one of the reasons is nobody's done it before. But there's really a true reason why I'm doing it like this. It's almost impossible to hold a small piece of wood in your hand and paint it without getting paint all over your hand and finger marks. So I adapted to make magnets and magnet holders that stand about 3 inches high, and I can paint the entire piece in one quick swoop. Come with me, Ralph, and I'll show you some of my other work. This is something cool. I'm only going to show you my magnetic work. Mm-hmm. Actually, this is probably the first piece I ever did in magnets. If you remember as a youngster, strips of licorice.
Yes.
With the little dots on it.
Yes.
Well, this is the funniest. I've donated about 3 of these pieces to the Museum of Art in Coral Springs because the director liked it. So I said, here, would you like a dot? Everyone got a kick. Can you put that on pause?
Yeah.
This is probably one of my second or third pieces I started with wood and magnets. These are store-bought balls made out of wood, adhered by magnets. And one night we're having a party right after I finished it, and I showed some of my guests, and I said, you know, I'd like a little lemon or lime in my vodka. By the way, that looks just like lemon or lime. So that's how it got the name lemon lime. But it's enjoyable for me to do something like this. I wear belts like this all the time.